Bleu. It works. You have absolutely no idea how happy I am to be here today. You know what? Because I get to touch the letters. And you see, there's even the red carpet. You know, you're not supposed to step off of the red carpet. Well, anyway, I have been a fan of TEDs and TEDxes for years now. Ideas worth spreading. Yep, seems legit. This is actually the kind of things that are completely obvious, but only as soon as someone told them. Ideas worth spreading. Like I said, I've been a fan of TEDs and TEDxes for years. I used to watch videos of, for example, the classics only, Ken Robinson on education, and then Hans Rosling on statistics. And I felt inside that this was somehow life-shaping. I knew that these guys could, in some way, change the world. So I promised myself, one day I'm going to do this. Just wait and see, and one day I'll be here. Touch the letters, step off the red carpet and such. But since I had absolutely no idea that was worth spreading, I didn't, and so I kept watching videos, such as Barry Schwartz on the happiness of choice. You seen this one? Okay, so this is me, flesh and blood. Feel free to answer when I ask you questions. Okay? Okay. And believe me, you don't want to miss Jill Taylor, a neurologist, who tells you the story of her very own stroke. It's an amazing story. And I kept watching videos and videos and videos up to a point in summer 2013 when my little brother, Daniel, now I know what you're thinking. Right now you are thinking, okay, it's his brother. He probably has a lot of pictures of him. So if he displayed this one, it's only because he wants to catch our attention. Yes, of course, but it's not my point. My point is I'm about to tell you how that very day he completely reshaped my life. And I want you to understand that beyond that, he's not different from any other student. He studies a lot, but he hangs out with his friends and he parties anytime he can. That being said, summer 2013, my little brother, he came to me and he told me, Bruce, there's something you must watch, like right now. And he showed me a video from a YouTube channel called Smarter Every Day. In this video, this guy, his name is Destined, he showed that a chicken, when you move its body, the head wants to stay in the same location in space. It's like a gyroscopic stabilizer. It's insane. And I thought it was amazing. And we can agree it's as amazing as it is hilarious, right? So what could I do? I just told my little brother, well, show me more. And more he showed me, oh yeah. So he showed me other videos of Smarter Every Day, videos of chickens, of snakes, spiders, raccoons, but not only animals, also videos about science, history, chemistry, biology, like Vsauce, Veritasium, CGP Grey, Minute Physics. I'm not advertising here. It's just that I really think everybody should see those channels and many more, because the list goes on and on and on. And they all have something in common. They share, no, they don't share, they spread the same idea. We all have knowledge we can share. And then it hit me. All right, maybe I don't need an idea, a very own idea that would be worth spreading. Because when you have an idea that is worth spreading, you still need people to spread it. So maybe this is what I can do. I have a little knowledge. Maybe I can help spreading this. And so, in 2013, in September, I started my own channel on YouTube. It's called Y Penser, it's in French. in which I make videos, of course, and I ask questions, mostly scientific questions, because really that's what I do, and I answer them the most complete way I can. My only rule is that I use no mathematics. I use no equations, no formulas. Try to explain it in plain English. And obviously, when I say plain English, I mean plain French. Parce que je suis le français. And it goes something like this.
Ma première question, ça va être la suivante. Selon vous, est-ce que c'est la Terre qui tourne autour du Soleil ou le Soleil qui tourne autour de la Terre?
Pourquoi Internet est-il le royaume des chats?
Combien est-ce que l'être humain a de sens? Pourquoi les Anglais roulent-ils du mauvais côté?
Pourquoi la relativité restreinte s'appelle la relativité restreinte?
Quand on souffle sur sa main la bouche ouverte, c'est chaud. Quand on souffle sur sa main la bouche fermée, c'est froid.
Partez tout droit. Tout droit, tout droit, tout droit. Vous vous arrêtez jamais. Vous allez revenir à temps.
Wow!
Un univers fini. Et sans bord.
Mais ça pose quand même la question des files d'attente.
Voilà. By the way, this is only a trailer. My videos are just not just me asking questions a lot. And all right, okay. So, most speakers who come at TED or TEDx, they come because they are exceptional people, or because they do something exceptional, or because they did something exceptional. No. So, neither am I exceptional, nor is what I do. I really believe that what I do, many people could do it. But what I do believe is that this, what I do, is part of something bigger. It's part of something exceptional because there obviously has been a lot of channels before I create my own, and there has been a lot ever since. No, since then, it's more correct. Yeah, since then. And I can appreciate that, but what I found, really, what I'm very proud of, is that of those channels who were created after my own, over a dozen creators came and told me directly that I had inspired them into creating their own channel. Now, don't get me wrong. I'm not saying that they wanted to do the things the way I do. It's just that watching me doing my thing, it gave them the guts to do it. And so, inspiration makes it work. Why not? Okay, it's easy at a TED to get an applause with this. I'm aware of that. No problem. I can take it. So I think this should be our new mantra. Inspiration make it work, makes it work. And it works actually great because in, what, a little bit over 18 months now, I have raised an audience of more than 300,000 people for a video channel in French about science. I have a video about special relativity that has been literally seen over 500,000 times. And it's the real deal. I mean, it's time dilation, length contraction, time inclination, it's everything. 500,000 times. That's insane. And this is how I understood that most people want to know more. They have an urge to know more. And this is how I found out that curiosity makes it work. And I think this should be our new mantra. And I get that the last one didn't last long, but that's okay. Or maybe we could switch from one to another. I don't know. Curiosity makes it work. And I'm sorry, but I'm about to, you know, spoiler alert. We're all going to die one day. Have a good one. But knowing that, I see no reason why we shouldn't share as much as we can with one another. And I really believe that curiosity is one of the most efficient tools we as human beings have to share information with one another. So, what can I tell you? If you know something that you can share, share it. And if you don't, first of all, I don't believe that, but let's assume you don't. If you don't know anything that you can share, well, get curious, learn something that you can share, and then share it. This is why, and I'll leave you with that question, what can you do to make it work? And I thank you.